This is my new place. It's got no furniture in it. Not even supposed to move in yet. I'm moving in tomorrow. So I've got an empty apartment here. I think I should show you around. Front door. Kitchen. Dining room. Lounge room. Study. Laundry. Bathroom. Ridiculously long wardrobe. Bedroom. Pokemon Go spawns. 7. And this is the place that I'm going to turn into my studio for YouTube. It has not only one, not only two, but three walls that I can use as YouTube backgrounds. Okay, now that's out of the way, the real reason I'm here a day early is because I'm going to shoot a virtual tour of this empty space. Furniture's coming in tomorrow morning and I want a clean record of this place while the walls are still bare and I can see every last inch of this place. And why is that? Well, firstly, I want to simulate what furniture is going to look like and how much space it's going to take up before everything comes in. Why else? Because I want to document this place so I can know exactly what it looked like the day I moved in. If there's any marks or anything, I'll know that they were there before I moved in. Right here, there's a mark on the wall. Generally, the walls are quite good, but this is one of the only marks I found. I want to make sure my landlords know that this was here before I moved in, and it wasn't because of the massive YouTube backdrop I'm gonna put here. Finally, so I can do a before and after of this place, empty and then with furniture. So years from now, I'll be able to do another virtual tour and see exactly how things changed and see the history of this space that I know I'm going to have some epic adventures and shoot some amazing videos in. A little boxes on the hillside, a little boxes made of ticky-tacky, little boxes on the hillside, a little boxes all the same. There's the blue one and the pink one and the green one and the yellow one, and they're all made of ticky-tacky and they all look just the same. And the boxes on the hillside, a little boxes made of ticky-tacky, little boxes on the hillside, a little boxes all the same. There's the one and the pink one and the green one and the yellow one, and they're all made of ticky-tacky and they all look just the same. And the boxes on the hillside. Now I'm going to change weapons, and this time I'm going to shoot the same virtual tour but for documentation purposes, which is where the higher resolution of the Mi Sphere is going to come in handy. I don't need perfect dynamic range, but just for getting every detail in the wall and the floor, I'm going to try it out and I'm going to show you how you can shoot a virtual tour in 2 minutes or less. Yeah, that's right, you can do it. You need to shoot handheld, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to hold the camera above my head, duck and walk around slowly. I'm putting the camera in time-lapse mode. So it's going to take a photo every 0.5 seconds or every 2 seconds. I will point out that you won't want to shoot like this for clients. This is purely for documentation. So it doesn't matter if I'm in the reflection of a mirror or if I'm in shot at the nadir, because I'm shooting this only for my own records. That's 2 minutes. I'm done and the sun's setting, so I'm gonna take an awesome shot for Instagram. Wait, it wasn't a dream, was it? No! No, I'm just kidding. I'm here in my new place and a week has passed since that last scene, and basically all of my stuff has been moved and I've bought most of my new furniture. Before I shoot my after version of the virtual tour, I have some really exciting news. My very first YouTube set is ready to go. I'm going to have about 5 or 6 throughout this place, but the first one is good to go. So let me give you an exclusive first look. God, how cool is this thing? so cool.
Okay, enough monkeying around. I've uploaded my photos to Cupix and my virtual tour has generated. And I want to show you a bunch of cool stuff that I think will give you ideas next time you go out shooting. Firstly, something really cool I discovered is the measurement tool. So if you click the ruler, you can measure how far it is between two points of your image. So I want to go from one corner to the other of my studio here. There we go, I've placed a line and it's saying 2.63 meters. You might be thinking, how does it know that? That's probably not accurate. And that's what I thought too, but then I went and physically measured this and guess how long it is. It's 2.65 meters. So this tool is extremely accurate. And say it wasn't for some reason, say it said 2.5, you can double click it and overrule it. You can say, hey, this is 2.65 meters, and it then learns that. And that is now the scale that it applies to every measurement going forward. So it's going to be even more accurate when I measure this wall and this wall and every wall in this entire place. Okay, I'm gonna pause this screen recording and I'm going to go physically measure this wall just to see how accurate it is. Be right back. Okay, I'm back at my computer, tape measure in hand. And guess what the measurement was? It was 2.45 meters. That is incredible. And I could see how this would be really handy if you're trying to predict the overall size of the place. If you didn't have access to your site, then this would be a super handy feature. Next, I'm going to document the damage to this wall. And remember the little mark from earlier? Here it is. And I want to put a note there so I know exactly where it is in the house. I don't have to go looking for it. So I'm going to go to Insert Pushpin, and we're going to choose pick a common point from two panos. So the mark is there and roughly about here on this pano. And now we want to give it a label. I'm going to say mark on wall and small scratch. So that way, next time we revisit our virtual tour, we'll see that's exactly where the mark is. You could also use this feature to include info about things in your tour. So say this phone thing, if I wanted to put instructions about how to use it. Say if this was an Airbnb, you could put instructions for different areas of the house within the actual 3D space. Now that is quite cool. Now I'm going to show you how you can simulate an object within your virtual tour. And this was particularly helpful for me when I was moving house because this is my bedroom. It's not massive and we have a big bed we were moving in. And we were really worried, would this bed fit into this space? And will we have enough space to comfortably walk around it? So here's what I did to solve that problem. I went to Insert Box. And what I did was create a box that represents the bed. Of course, measurements are going to be super important here, so I had the measurements of the bed, and it was as simple as typing them into width, height, and depth. Okay, that looks right. Now I'm going to hit lock movement, and we have an object in our space. Yes, it doesn't look like a bed, it looks like a box, but it gave me a really good idea of how well this bed would fit into this space. And now you can walk around the virtual tour. Is there enough space? Yes, there is on both sides. So this was a lifesaver and meant on moving day, I didn't have to stress about the bed not fitting into the bedroom. Now I'm going to show you something mind-blowing, which is one of the coolest uses of virtual tours I've probably ever seen. So I'm going to go over to the publisher, and on the right, there's a compare list options. So I've gone ahead and reshot this entire virtual tour with all my furniture in place. So I have two virtual tours that I want to compare side by side. I'm going to hit the plus symbol, and now I'm going to choose Ben's apartment after. So it knows when the virtual tour player comes up, it's going to have an option to compare two tours. So on the left, I have my before, and on the right, I have my after. Keep in mind that I wouldn't have got my placement exactly right. As you can see on the left, I put the tripod one tile closer to the bathroom, but it doesn't matter so much as long as it's relatively close to where it was. Cupix will figure out the closest pano and bring the viewpoint to the closest pano to the one on the left. Now wait for it, I'm going to step into my new apartment and see the true before and after. Look at this. Oh my god, this is so cool. It's like stepping back in time. This is my new apartment. I can't believe this. I'm so happy with the furniture I got. But look at the difference between that completely empty apartment and how I furnished it. It just looks incredible. I've got to say, this is so fun to look at. I can't wait to shoot another virtual tour in, say, 3 or 4 years and see how this space changes yet again. I could see how this would be really handy for documenting the changes of business places, like restaurants, offices, anywhere where the display changes, say, every few years. It would be especially helpful with construction sites where there's lots and lots of changes happening quickly for builders to be able to track the progress relatively quickly and see it side by side like this. As you can see, the bed fit in nicely, and this is my bedroom. It's not massive, but it has a view of Sydney City right through there. It's a very nice sight to wake up to.
I really like it.
No.
Yes.
She wants to buy this painting for this wall. Firstly, it's way too bright, but also it's over a meter by a meter. We don't have enough space. If only there were a way to simulate what this painting is going to look like on the wall before we buy it.
It's too big. It's too big.
Yes, woo! We don't have to get it. Oh, I'm so happy.
What about that wall?
By the way, more exciting news. Look what I got in the mail. It's the Kendall Goo Cam. Yes, it's the camera with the new funniest name of all the 360 cameras. I have it in my hands right now. Look, it's still really early and I'm reluctant to release too much info about it only because they're going to be updating it so much in the next month or two. So I'm going to wait a bit before I make a review. I'll tell you guys as much as I know, but really it's going to be a complete camera in the next 1 to 2 months. So I'll release more content then. How cool is this backdrop looking, by the way? So cool. I'm going to take a coup selfie. Okay, 3, 2, 1, coup! So that's it. That's my exciting news. We will be resuming regular programming ASAP. So hit that subscribe button and be sure you don't miss out on all the awesome tutorials I have coming your way, covering 360 photos, 360 video, tiny planets, and just whatever weird and wacky stuff I think of on the day. So that's all from me. If you're not capturing your world in 360 today, then just get out there and go do it. Little boxes on the hillside, a little boxes on the